Hi, I'm William White, composer of the Stabat Mater that is going to be premiered this Sunday at Femme Love. This is a piece for soprano, mezzo-soprano, viola, and piano, but it would be more accurate to say that this is a piece for Arwin Myers, Laura Thoreson, viola, and piano. I have known Arwin and Laura since we sang in choir together at Indiana University. We've since gone on to do a number of projects together, so I feel that I know their voices very well, and I wanted to write something specifically tailored to them. This is a piece, the idea for which was dreamed up when Arwin and I were at St. Paul's Cathedral in the crypts. We were actually at the cafe having tea and scones, but we were talking about different ideas to do with feminine love. And the idea that I wanted to explore was the love between a mother and a son. And here we were surrounded by this religious context, and so we started talking about the Stabat Mater, which is a 13th century Latin hymn that talks about Mary's suffering as she sees her son on the cross. I wanted to take this idea, take the Latin of the original hymn and to juxtapose it with contemporary contexts. So I found sources related to war mothers, American mothers whose sons died in Iraq and Afghanistan, mothers whose sons died in the AIDS crisis, and mothers whose sons died at the hands of police brutality in contexts that we would now think of as the Black Lives Matter movement. So this is a real tearjerker. That was something that I wanted to do from the beginning. I don't know why. There was just something about the voices and the context that I thought would be really moving. The viola part sort of represents the sun, and that's partially because viola is my instrument as an instrumentalist. I'm very pleased that this is the viola part is going to be played by Kenji Bunch, who is a composer I've known about since I was a teenager, so it's kind of like I'm a little bit starstruck by that. And then the piano part sort of rounds out and contextualizes these three different characters. So the soprano is intoning the Latin text in sort of a disembodied, ethereal soundscape. And then the mezzo-soprano is much earthier, and the mezzo-soprano sings the words from these contemporary sources. So to me, that's like that's more of the gut punch side of it. And then the viola has interludes that are sort of ghostly and painful and poignant. So you know, these things all come together in this piece that to me is a very deep piece, and it's one that I'm really looking forward to sharing with everybody.